want to take a chance and risk getting knocked out.
Oh, my God. Oh, wow.
Wow.
It is all over.
I couldn't have timed that word knockout any better.
There's no denying that the sport of mixed martial arts has come a long way since its inception, but one thing has stayed the same since the start. Fans love knockouts. Sure, a well-timed out-and-out-of-nowhere submission will get the fans cheering, but it still doesn't compare to the roar to the crowd after they've witnessed a brutal KO inside the cage. The knockouts that really leave their mark on fans are the ones that end the fight abruptly, leaving one fighter sprawled out on the canvas while the other celebrates sweet victory. Here are the hardest knockouts in MMA history. Gabriel Gonzaga vs. Mirko Krokop. Look up Mirko Krokop, and what you'll find is his highlight reel of his vicious head kick knockouts. Which is why his loss to UFC heavyweight Gabriel Gonzaga back in 2007 was a painful dose of irony. In Krokop's second fight under the UFC banner, he ended up getting Krokopped himself when Gonzaga blasted him with a kick that sent the Pride legend crumbling to the canvas.
He gets him again. I could snap some ribs, man.
Mirko looks tentative, though.
Oh, my God!
Rashad Evans vs. Sean Salmon. Rashad Evans won the second season of The Ultimate Fighter and was undefeated with 4 UFC fights under his belt when he took on Sean Salmon at UFC Fight Night 8. But it was his fight finishing KO against Salmon that really put his name on the map and got the fans' attention. Early in the second round, Evans uncorked a head kick that put Salmon out instantly.
Early second round.
Rashad Evans vs. Chuck Liddell. Evans' KO of Sean Salmon might have gotten the fans' attention, but his brutal, soul-crushing knockout of legendary champion Chuck the Iceman Liddell left them speechless. Liddell was going after Evans and walking him back towards the cage, but it was there in the second round that Sugar unleashed his booming right hand that caught Liddell right on the chin. Unfortunately for Liddell, he suffered a few more hard-to-watch KO losses before finally hanging up his gloves.
Liddell with a big right hand.
Chuck is bleeding.
Yep.
It's on that right cheek, Joe. Chuck. Good right hand by Chuck. And Rashad is being lured into exchange. He landed a right hand, though. He landed a left.
Oh, big uppercut. He's out cold. Down. Rashad Evans has no
out cold.
Quinton Rampage Jackson versus Ricardo Arona. The saying for hardcore MMA fans is pride never dies, but if your name is Ricardo Arona, maybe you'd wish it had. Back in 2004, Pride FC was going strong over in Japan, and it featured some of the best fighters in the world. One of those fighters was Quinton Rampage Jackson, more commonly known to the fans simply as Rampage. Before Rampage made his way over to the UFC, where he would dethrone longtime champ Chuck Liddell, he was busy in Pride, powerbombing fighters into unconsciousness. Dan Henderson vs. Michael Bisping. Before Michael Bisping was wearing the UFC middleweight title around his waist and getting ready to fight George St. Pierre, he was on a little TV show called The Ultimate Fighter, where he coached the opposite of UFC and Pride legend Dan Henderson. Everyone knew the two would fight after the conclusion of the show, but no one imagined just how brutally it would end. Bisping ended up becoming just another long list of H-bomb victims. He almost did it again in their long-anticipated rematch, but Bisping survived the hold on to his belt. Fedor Emelianenko vs. Andrei Arlovski. When it comes to heavyweights, it's known that all it takes is one punch to drastically change the fight, and there's no better example than that of the punch Fedor landed against former UFC champion Andrei Arlovsky. The two met back in 2009 when they fought for the WAMMA Heavyweight Championship in the Infliction organization. Things have been going well for the Pitbull, who is backing the man against many believe the greatest heavyweight of all time against the ropes. Arlovsky landed a nice push kick that sent Fedor back into the corner. But as soon as Arlovsky jumped in for a flying knee, he was caught midair by Fedor's devastating right hand that immediately caused him to go limp and drop. Paul Daly vs. Scott Smith. Deadly striker Paul Daly looked to be on his way to a UFC title shot heading into his third fight into the octagon against top contender Josh Koscheck. However, things didn't go Daly's way and he lost the decision, leading to an infamous punch after the bell that got him banned from the UFC. After that mishap, Daly made his way to Strikeforce and delivered another highlight reel knockout, this time against veteran Scott Smith. Joe Schilling vs. Hisaki Kato. Going into the Bellator fight between Joe Schilling and Hisaki Kato, not many gave the unknown Kato much of a chance, especially if the fight stayed on the feet. After all, Schilling had made a name for himself as a world-class kickboxer. However, when it was all said and done, it was Schilling bouncing off the canvas after Kato delivered a stunning shot that put his lights out. Plenty of fans knew who he was after that.
He said, "I'm a small glove fighter."
That is a famous knockout for sure against the world-class kickboxer. This crowd appreciates it.
Rampage versus Wanderlei Silva. Rampage versus the Axe Murderer. How could this fight not end in a devastating fashion? The two had a history, having already faced each other twice back in Pride, with Silva winning both fights via brutal knees. It seems for Rampage, the third time really was a charm because he put Silva to sleep with one huge left hand. There's a reason fans love to watch both of these fighters compete. Uriah Hall vs. Adam Cella. The Ultimate Fighter reality show has produced some of the biggest names in the sport during its long run. However, there might not have been a fighter that has had as much hype surrounding them coming off the show as Uriah Hall. Not only because he managed to make it to the finale, but because he did so in impressive fashion with three of his four fights ending in KOs. But one of those knockouts stood out from all the rest and to this day might be the best finish in tough history. Poor Adam Cella will probably always be known as the guy who got KO'd by Hall's crazy spin kick.
A couple more! More after.
Jose Aldo versus Conor McGregor. After all the trash talk, a 12-day world tour, countless promotional interviews, and face-offs, Jose Aldo and Conor McGregor's fight was scrapped due to injury. After McGregor dispatched replacement Chad Mendez, the two were then rescheduled to unify the featherweight title. After all that, it only took 13 seconds for the Irishman to send who many believe was the pound-for-pound best fighter in the world, crashing down to the mat unconscious. McGregor would then go on to fight at welterweight, challenge four, and win the lightweight title and fight Floyd Mayweather in a boxing match. What's next for McGregor? We'll have to wait and see.
Here we go!
Green trunks for the southpaw, the notorious Conor McGregor. Black trunks for the champion, Jose Aldo Jr.
Conor relaxed and smiling.
Oh!
Ronda Rousey versus Holly Holm. On November 14th, 2015, it seemed just about everyone believed UFC champion Ronda Rousey was untouchable inside the octagon. Rousey had blown up into a mainstream superstar and was undefeated at 12-0, with all but one of her fights finishing in the first round. What a difference a day makes. On the 15th, Rousey suffered one of the most brutal knockouts in UFC history when fellow undefeated fighter Holly Holm knocked her into the stratosphere via thunderous head kick. Was it the greatest upset in UFC history? Perhaps. We didn't see Ronda again until she returned more than a year later to take on new champ Amanda Nunes. Things didn't go much better for her that time around either.
Turn mixed martial arts.
The sport of MMA will continue to grow and expand, but the appeal of a fight-finishing strike that ends a fighter crumbling, face-planting, or falling stiff as a board will always remain amongst fans. Can you think of any other MMA knockouts that deserve to be on this list? Let us know in the comments below. Thanks for watching the hardest knockouts in MMA history.